Penn's a little closer. The score line just beaten in as everybody's going towards that forward hit first.
That TP is going to be crucial there for Scuffy, of course, looking for those spawns ready for P2P wield.
Just playing time, playing bomb. Trauma's got this longer line of sight. Shields knows that he's got the AR. Trauma's a very skilled AR player, so all Shields needs to do is get him into medium to
low. Oh my god!
Oh my god! Wow, that headshot just instantaneously melts Shield. Right. On the up here, 3v3. Crook just looking for a player. He sees Crit in the corner, spots him, takes him down, beams him. That was a very beautiful pick right there. 2-1. Oh my god. Crook, what are you doing? One more, there's just one more. He split right by him. I think Paralysis is going to get picked off. No, Bridge is going to get one. He's distracted. This might not be in time. Oh my god.
Position, but Illini look very good towards the end there. Versus to get a beautiful three-piece out of bomb of a nade onto the opposition. Trauma here. Oh my god, what a play of the game. The three-piece with that M4, just showing how versatile they can be in this game. Yep, great performance from Concord Maroon. Their ninth map straight. They are undefeated still going into the semi-finals here. They have passed the top 8 and have gained themselves top 4 status in their second CCL tournament of Modern Warfare. What a great performance. A statement once again.
Though, is blocking down all of his teammates from coming in his spot. He's going to find himself 3-4 in a row. He's on 7 straight. It's 4 straight in that spree, though, as he will be the main person for the wipe. Paralysis for more. He's got 9. Stop contesting him.
Oh, my God.
The window. 10 straight for Paralysis. 16-5 before he falls. They're Rutgers, the Scarlet Knights. 5-0 here in the search and destroy. Let's be candid here, Robert. They were smacked on the Hackney Yard hardpoint, and they are showing that that very well may have been a fluke, because this Ramazza S&D has been all Rutgers all the time. They're in favor of Concord Maroon, likely. Unless this is amazing to happen to the next
another couple of mistakes as far as Rutgers setup. Again, they don't have the ability to win up the middle. We will find a nice 1v1 there. Find another, he was too low.
It's a little bit more doable if you're Lou, if you can know your angles, you have to be picking out the angle was already being held 3 rounds in sequence of one another. And Concord Maroon, how monumental would it be to come back from a 5-0 deficit to win this out? They still have to win the next 3 to do so, but they are looking a lot cleaner than they were at the beginning of this SMD.
Top mid where he finds the pistol, but it's gonna be down to bomb got planted, but it will be defused. And goodness, again, if you just let Lou make that flank happen before it's out of your Rutgers, you at least fuck down Wendy's now by themselves. And all of a sudden, we are tied 5-5, round 11. Oh, man.
That gave me a flashback. That gave me a flashback to Hardpoint right there. They're just playing so decisive. You know what these players want, Concord Maroon. Not only the W, but how they're just decisively...
to find a way to find this kill Z stairs to the left. It's going to be a little bit easier said than done, though. Reckless is the first player to come on in. Trauma for one. Look for another.
The gun!
He will not find the kill. For Maroon wins 6 round straight, the full sail, down 0-5, they win the flat out 6-0 here to win the round 11. Someone needs to go make sure that Rutgers doesn't need the Heimlich maneuver. The case here, Trauma able to line one up at the top of the yellow rug shop, looking for another protocol, will find the kill, and actually wins the second. Opportunity with that to swing at least the influence over the cave. I guess the good news for now, the silver lining, is Rutgers are still holding out of the spawn, but Crook has nothing to say about it! He takes down 3! Take as many body shots as you want! To that fifth hill, the Cliff Hut, on the backside, Megatron, 1v1 versus Reckless. This is a massive one. First couple of shots come through. Trauma's also trying to pinch. Reckless gets snapped on. It's 9-200. Red Chase holding on to his life for Concord. The Rim Paralysis over the top. Trauma there, but Yodi comes up big again. Nobody there to touch. Yodi found 2. The third one was lined up. But Concord, all they needed to do was put one pinky toe on, and Yobi not able to get the kill in time. It was a tall ask for him to essentially find six straight that life, all of which were in clutch fashion. And Concord Maroon will get through Rutgers Scarlet at a scoreline of 250 to 200.
Drama is well-defined money. Immediately, we find ourselves in a 3v2 as straights are coming across the board, but Crooked is just going and sliding into everybody's DMs now. Taking a look at it, while you still have a player in the mid and a player on top of the smokestack, just seeing if there's a rotation to come through. Now, there is a player that was inside the office, will be gunned down by Astro, but how about Trauma? Those shots are real good as well. We'll get the third as well onto Astro. Trauma, a one-man war machine, is starting to slide back into the bomb site. Beef finds a fourth. Can anybody stop this man?
It's gonna have to come down just to stop 1v1 Trauma for all five. Silence back
over the top, nearly almost connects with Trauma. Actually, he's got that silence. 1v1 catches Peyton coming through the window by AC. Now down.
Oh my goodness!
Concord Maroon takes another round, and it's Trauma coming up big again with the MP5.
Look at the no hesitation, jumping on in. Oh, Chance, what shots coming through there. Astro, and now Crooked Paralysis know where they are, but wrong angle to be looking at. Crooked gets taken down by Astro, and now Paralysis committing towards the bomb defuse. Can't commit all the way, but Paralysis will gun down Astro. So this defuse will come in full, and it will be two maps up and two maps down for Concord Maroon. Up to that cubby side, knowing that there's going to be a few players rotating from the train tracks, will get taken care of. However, that's Trauma with another two pieces working their way into this beef.
Five-man wipe.
Dom site. This is just wild. Commanding rotations and forcing their way into the B Dom, turning it back in their favor. Raging Cajuns back into their spawn onto A, and just Trauma going off right into the warehouses, not letting them leave.
This is just absolute insult meet injury, flipping the spawns around. It'll be an A-B hold here now for Concord. They will not get the full Duptic special. He will not, and that'll be the B-flag likely going the way up the side of Concord.
We'll line him up!
Get with two! Almost a third. He'll get the assist. Red Chase with the kill.
100-point margin here with just 2 minutes left, and you almost have to think it is all said and done for the Raging Cajun squad, and Concord Maroon will be your grand finalist and victor of this 2020 intro tournament to the CCL, and by God, did they do it just so definitively.
Three tournament wins in a row across the Black Ops 4 farewell, the welcoming in Modern Warfare, and here on the season kickoff tournament, Concord Maroon will be your champions as they surpass the 210 point mark, a minute and 30 to play, and likely just a victory lap here for Concord. Jeez. Paralysis taking down three as he's just continuing to have himself a day.
Who they say they are. And well, when you have a team with Crooked, Red Chase, Megatron, and Trauma, can't say it enough, a team full of five that have any opportunity, they will pop off. They are a commanding team, or a very scary team in CCL. And this is a team, regardless of what other region that you play in, you have to be very fearful of.
I mean, commanding, dominating. Pick your adjective, buy as many consonants or vowels as you want to make the word happen. They have earned every title so far. And they, without a doubt, as time hits zero, Concord Maroon, they are the team to beat when it comes to the CCL in season number two. You cannot debate me on the fact. The facts speak for themselves. Three tournament wins since they've entered the CCL. They're technically undefeated when it comes to that. Have not dropped a set yet. Have never seen a loser's bracket. Have never seen anything without a W in the title of it. And they once again will be your champions here of the kickoff tournament, and they should be feeling damn good going into the regular season start next week.
I mean, look at these KDs across the board. 32, 17, 33 and 20, 33 and 19, Paralysis, Crook. We saw Trauma. It just time and time again throughout that entire map of domination, just finding two, three pieces. Paralysis was right there, as well as Crook, just taking command of all these flanks, the trees, all the way past the coal mine into the A-Dom site, which was the spawn of the Raging Cajuns, by the way. had such a hard time breaking past. There was only one player on the Raging Cajuns that didn't have a death rate past 30, and that was Bandit, who also found a good series of kills. Nevertheless, none of those players able to go positive, and that's just the scary commanding team that we have known to come and see for Concord Maroon.